Hi all, welcome once again to Learn News. Today it's a tutorial about deploying a Spring Boot application in Heroku app. Just like AWS has Elastic Beanstalk and Azure has App Services, both of them are costly and they require certain amount of cost unless and until you have a free tier you're using within free tier. But Heroku app is something that is a company that is powered by Salesforce. And it's an app service just like that of just like an app deployment platform where you can deploy your app and host it, but their particular DNS that will be exposed will contain certain Heroku app notations. Let us quickly come on to our code base that we are going to use. It's a very simple Spring Boot application where we are going to get exposing one hello endpoint, and that is going to return a hello result. Just like, let me come over here to source main, and here inside the Docker demo, this is a Spring Boot Docker demo application. Please ignore the term Docker here. We are telling Docker in this case. So this here simply a request mapping is there, and it's a REST controller. We are exposing it, and this is one of the endpoint that is being exposed. Like get mapping here hello, and we are returning this hello. So we are quickly, what we are going to do is create an application. So this is Heroku app. Okay, if you come on to here, this is the dashboard, and it's powered by Salesforce, and it's a company of Salesforce rather. Here multiple things are there, like dashboard. Let me come over here to dashboard, data clips, elements, documentation, support, and this is my account over here. And there multiple account settings are supported. This is the logo for home. So this is the personal dashboard. So what I'm going to do is click on this new, create new app. I can also create a new pipeline. So let us give some sensible name over here. I'm creating a simple app here. Spring Boot REST API. Okay, and it's available. The name, it will search and it will see that whether it's available or not. Let me create it, and here you will find land into different options here. You can choose a pipeline if you have a particular pipeline like scripted just like that of Jenkins. Other than that, and there are deployment methods which either it can be through GitHub, through Heroku Git, or container registry. So what I'm going to do is, since my code is in GitHub, I'm going to connect over here GitHub, and here I will search for my repository, particular repository which I want to build, which is this one, Spring Boot REST API, and I'm going to connect it. And this is the job that you have to do only. And our application is just one click away from deployment here. The particular branch you can select, whether it's a master branch or it's a any particular feature branch or develop branch that you want to deploy in your environment. And let's deploy the branch, and here in this build you will see that it's looking for the Maven dependency and downloading all the dependencies. Had it been Gradle also, the same thing would have happened. It will go and search for the dependencies and download it from Maven repository, and after that one you will find it's compressing, building the jar and deploying it to its environment, and finally the endpoint URL being exposed. Yeah, let us view it. Well, it is giving an error because this particular root is not exposed as a particular endpoint, but as an endpoint what I have exposed is hello. Let us see quickly, and yes, you can see that this endpoint hello is displaying this hello keyword, hello world. Okay, so it's a very simple way which you can see here that we have created a GitHub from a GitHub project repository. We have created an application and deployed the same in Heroku app. It's a very simple way. It's a very simple process that is being followed over here. There are other steps which you can try out, like the deployment method, whether it's a Heroku Git or whether through its container registry, whether it's a Docker image which you want to pull and build and deploy that in your Heroku app. So it's a very simple way which you can do it. So hope you like it. And just before concluding, we are going to delete this one since we do not need it right now. Moreover, it's free, it's not a problem for us. If you have to go to settings over here, you have to scroll down. You can also adjust your configure your own SSL certificate. Upgrade to paid dynos to configure a Heroku SSL certificates over here. Or also you can add your own domain because this particular DNS contains HerokuApp.com. If you don't like it, you can add it to a DM through Cloudflare and all other facilities that are present. Let me delete the app. Here, what I need to do is just give the name of the app over here. Yeah, given. Delete app. It's deleted. So let me conclude the session over here, like in this way that these are very simple way which you can deploy your application. You can say spend, you can spend lesser money, or you can save your money if you want to deploy it in Heroku app other than AWS Elastic BeanStack or Azure App Services. This is one of the best example which you can have. Hope you like it, my channel. Hope you're liking Learn News. Stay tuned to my channel for more interesting videos and tutorials in the forthcoming sessions. Thank you.